Ladies and gentlemen, liebe Landsleute, dear all. I want to welcome you all to our digital celebration on the Day of German Unity. For my wife Ingrid and me, this is our second German National Day in Bangalore, and we sincerely hope and truly believe that will be our last digital reception on October 3rd. Next year, we wish to see you in person. Nonetheless, we are happy to have you to join us on this joyous occasion, and we have an exciting program ahead. Today we celebrate for the 31st time the reunification of Germany. After the Second World War, Germany was divided into a Western Zone, occupied by the US, Great Britain and France, and into a Eastern Zone, occupied by the Soviet Union. After a peaceful revolution in East Germany in 1989, Germany became one again in October 3rd, 1990. At that time, I still was a student aspiring to go to the Foreign Service. It is a cherished tradition that on our National Day, we highlight inter-German relations, and more specifically, the work of the German Consulate General does in Karnataka and Kerala. Around me, you can see the beautiful botanical garden of Lal Bagh in Bangalore, which is a true symbol of how India and Germany are interconnected. A German who is responsible for some of the most beautiful gardening you can see behind me and all throughout the parks and streets of Bangalore. As part of our cultural work at the consulate, you will be hearing and seeing more about Hermann Krumbiegel soon. It is really fascinating to learn more about this very interesting person and his life. He actually lived near to where I was standing. Of course, the heart of our mission is to strengthen economic and academic ties between Karnataka, Kerala and Germany. There are about 200 German companies operating and flourishing in Karnataka and Kerala, such as SAP, Daimler, Bosch, Festo, Siemens and many medium and small enterprises being active in domains such as research and development, manufacturing, automotive, health, transport. I want to highlight that some of these companies are looking to expand their businesses in this part of India, such as Siemens Healthineers. They are building an innovation hub in Bangalore and they're looking to invest and recruit heavily. Fortunately, business cooperation is not only a one-way street. Recently, we have seen more and more Indian companies looking to set up their businesses or invest in Germany. Companies are looking at Germany to make their presence in the European and global market. Wipro and Infosys are the latest examples for such collaboration. The pandemic has shown us that it is difficult to travel. But how important travel is for the relation between our two peoples? I want to commend all the Indian students who want to take up their studies in Germany. And as of right of now, there are more than 28,000 Indian students in Germany. Welcome to my home country. We try to promote and highlight Germany as a place of study and are delighted that there is such a fruitful cooperation between institutions of higher learning in Karnataka, Kerala and Germany. We are moreover relieved that restrictions for travel to Germany have loosened in the past couple of months, and we are working hard in the consulate to facilitate travel in these uncertain times. And that goes for everyone. Students, businessmen, businesswomen, Indians reuniting with their families in Germany, tourists, or everyone who wants to visit our beautiful country, Germany. This evening, we want to enjoy some of beautiful German jazz music, brought to you by the Klaus Graf Quartet, live from Germany. And who knows, we might even see Klaus Graf and his musicians in Bangalore in the coming year. That's a promise. Thank you for being with us, and have a great evening.
Good evening and welcome to tonight's episode of Live at MOCHER’s.
Namaskara Bengaluru. Namma ee sangeetha karyakramakke thamagellarigu swagatha. Enjoy Maadi.
Karyakramakke Thamagellarigu swagatha. Enjoy Maadi. Thank you. Welcome to Live at MOCHER’S Volume 52. Thank you so much for joining us for our concert on the celebrating day of the German unity. First, I like to introduce the wonderful musicians of my special quartet. The man on the piano, I know him since 35 years and he's one of my favorite piano players. That's Thilo Wagner. Over there, we have a drummer. He's also great in jazz and in Western classical music. Fantastic musician. That's Meinhard Obi Jenne on drums. On bass, my very dear friend since years, fantastic bass player, festival organizer, and especially a very good cook, Veit Hübner on the contrabass. Right now, actually, we would be in Bangalore for this live concert. Instead, we are very happy to play online for two audiences, for our dear friends in India and also for our German fans. We hope you will enjoy the concert. We started out with a tune composed by Victor Feldman. It was performed and recorded by Cannonball Adderley, one of my favorite alto saxophone player of all time. The tune was called Azule Serape. Azule Serape is the name of a clothing. It is a blue shawl, especially worn by men in South America. The next tune we play now is written by my own, and it is the title song of my second quartet record that I released in 2006. It is called Moving On. By the way, use the chat on the right side of the video screen. We would be happy to get in touch with you during the show. Well, you must have recognized that the last song was from the Beatles. But did you guess the name of the song? It was I Feel Fine. The next song now is called It Don't Mean a Thing. It don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. That's the feeling of jazz.
Thank you.
that was swinging, guys. The tune I will now play as a duo with Thilo is a ballad that I wrote a few years ago. It is called For Duke and is dedicated to the great composer and piano player Duke Ellington. Thank you.
Wonderful performance. Fort Duke, song written by our band leader Klaus Graf and accompanied by our wonderful piano player Thilo Wagner. I have the chat pad here in my hand, and it's great to see you all responding and writing to us. That some people just say absolutely stupendous, moving on. Beautiful and great, wonderful. And what I'm especially happy about is that also one Ramesh KP, an Indian, and also Achim Burkart from Germany, they loved our versions from the national anthems. And that's very important for us because we want to also show our respect to the wonderful people in India, and that was great fun playing your anthem too. And some people said, for example, Jagadish MR, love this tune, Klaus. You performed this at BSM in 2017. That's the Bangalore School of Music, and we've been there during our first India tour with the wonderful Klaus Graf Quartet, and I remember 100% like it was yesterday, how we were in this kind of small teaching room crowded with wonderful people, and we were exchanging our ideas of beautiful music and jazz. And from very near, from Klaus' hometown, Ma May, great performance and great studio. Greetings from Schöckingen, and also Ju Mari 93, wie immer großartiger Sound aus dem Mocher Studio. That's how we feel here in Mocher Studio with Patrick Tompert. We feel very, very good and everything's perfect. And people are also saying we look good, and this has to have something to do with all the cameras and with all the lightning, I'm sure. And fantastic performance. Looking forward to see you live. Sangeetha, Pasharati, Aaron Christopher. Nice to see Obi killing it. Thank you very much, Aaron. That's very, really nice. I love it. And Götz Schwab says, greetings from the Neckar, which is our river here. And it's nearly as nice as the Ganges in India. And that's how people write. And yes, enjoy it. We're gonna play one more suite, and this it's only for me, up to me to say I'm looking forward if we can make it to India next year and play for you live, and we enjoy this also, and we are really feeling very related and very very close to you, even if it's a few thousand miles away. And I give back to Klaus Graf, who will announce the next three songs he wrote.
Thank you so much, Obi. Yes, we're gonna play a suite, and it's called the Mysore Suite. The Mysore suite is dedicated to the town called Mysore. You might know it because it is in Karnataka and not far from Bangalore. We played there on our first India tour in 2017, and we made a lot of dear friends there. The illuminated palace left a deep impression on us and inspired me to write a suite in three pieces. The first set is called Light of Mysore. The second set is called Secret of Palace. And the third set is called The Game Goes On.
Thank you.
Once again, give a big hand for that great musician, Thilo Wagner on the grand piano, Obi Jenne on the drums, and Veit Hübner on the contrabass, on the bass. And also for this guy behind in the studio is incredible, Patrick Tompert and mochermusic. Thank you so much. We hope you enjoyed our show for that special day, celebrating the day of the German unity. Stay tuned if you like the show. You can watch next week Christoph Neuhaus and Martin van der Grinden, two fantastic guitar players on the same channel. And we would like to thank the Consul General of the Federal Republic of Germany, Mr. Achim Burkart, and Mrs. Ingrid Burkart, as well as the team of the German Consulate General Bengaluru for making this concert possible. Thank you so much. We are very glad to redeem the promise to come to the Bangalore Jazz Week next year. Thank you.
Dear jazz lovers, that was our show for tonight. Thanks for joining us, and we hope to see you again next time. So long, farewell, auf Wiedersehen, and goodbye. Love, Monica.